Say, Mom, say, I need this and I need that. I need some advice. Will you help me do this? And many times we say we're not, we don't want to, but we're always happy and we're always proud to help our children. And our God, our Father in heaven, is always proud to help us in the same manner. God told Rebecca, wait patiently, and we must trust God, even when we don't understand why events occur as they occur in our society. And I tell you, there's some stuff going on up in here in our society. And we're going to have to continue to trust in God. Luke 6 and 46 says, building on a solid foundation. So why do you call me Lord when you want obey me, is what God asks. I will show you what it is like when someone comes to me. Listen to my teaching and obey me. It is like a person who builds a house on a strained foundation laid upon the underlaid rock. When a strong foundation laid upon the underlaid rock, when the flood waters rise and break against the house, it stands firm because it is well built. But anyone who listens and doesn't obey is like a person who builds the house without a foundation. When the floods come, they sweep down against the house, and it will crumble into heaps of ruin. In Jude, we look at the foundation of faith. But you, my dear sisters, sisters and brothers, must remember what the apostle of the Lord Jesus Christ told you, that in the last days, strange things will go happen. People will be coming scoffers and with whose purposes in life is to enjoy themselves only. They'll be coming in every way imaginable. But you know what? They're already here. The Bible says in Jude 1 and 17, they are already here.
Yes, yes.
And they are the ones who are cheating and creating and divisions among you. They live by natural instinct because they do not have God's Spirit living inside of them. You know, a lot of times we have troubles in our homes because the Spirit of Christ is not on the inside of us. Mm-hmm. Amen? Mm-hmm. Somebody else say amen.
Yes.
Yes. But you, dear friends, must continue to build your life on the foundation of your holy faith and continue to pray as you are directed by the Holy Spirit. Live your life in such a way that God's love can bless you as you wait for the eternal life that our Lord Jesus Christ and His mercy is going to give you. You ought to. No, you must. You must show mercy to those whose faith is wavering. You must rescue others by snatching them from the flames of judgment. There are others still to whom you need to show mercy. But be careful now that you are not contaminated by and with their sins. All right. Told you I wasn't going to be long. I'm getting there. I am getting there. Let us look at a couple of points here. Number one, God has a watching eye. The psalmist told us that he's sitting up there. Oh, and every time I look up, I can just see the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hope he stays up there a while. I'm not ready for him to come down. God has a watching eye.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. And he's still on his throne in heaven. There's a song that I love to listen to. I have it in my truck. And this young lady sings that thing so powerful. And she says, God's got a watching eye. And he watches everything that we do. Praise the Lord. And if you dig a ditch for me, you might as well dig too. Because the very dig that you did you might end up falling into. Praise the Lord. God is still, I guess I got that name right. God is still in charge. He is watching everything, and he's watching everybody. Yes. He's watching the wicked and the righteous.
Yes.
Secondly, in Habakkuk 2 and 3. Patiently wait on the Lord, folks. There's no point in anxiety. You just be patient. And you wait on the Lord. For we must trust God even when God seems to be slow. Well, the prophet reminds us that God will surely come through. So whatever you are waiting on God to do, also, you just keep on waiting on God. Whatever you are trusting God to do for you, whatever you pray, whatever you need, don't you stop praying, don't you stop trusting God, you keep on believing that God is going to deliver. Every now and then, God just wants to see how determined you are. He just wants to see if you mean what you pray. Every now and then, we fall on our face and we pray for something, but we don't really mean it. Praise the Lord, because when a strong wind comes, we'll start to run. Amen. Thank you. 2:1 reminds us that we must continue to build our lives on the foundation out of our holy faith and continue to pray as we are directed by the Holy Spirit. Isn't that right?
Yes.
Praise the Lord. So what can the righteous do? We can wait on the Lord.
Yes.
We can trust on the Lord.
Yes.
We can believe that the Lord is who he is. We got to have faith in order to call on God. Faith without works, no good.
Yes.
You got to have faith. You can't just start praying and then give up on God, because God didn't give up on you. He reminds us that we must continue to build our lives on the foundation of our holy faith and continue to pray as we are directed by the Holy Spirit. In trying to find common ground with those to whom we witness to.
Yes,
you need to call witness to folk.
Yes.
Yeah. And sometimes you need to find common ground with those whom you witness. We must be careful not to fall into the quicksand of compromise. When we reach out to others, we must be sure that our own faith is safe and secure.
Yes.
We must be careful not to be so much like non-Christians that we can tell. Oh, y'all don't see where I'm going. Let me try that again. My mind is getting cold. Be careful not to be so much like non-Christians that no one can tell who you are or what you believe. Praise the Lord. We've got to be careful that we don't get contaminated. Influence them for Christ. And don't allow them to influence you to sin. The end of the world is coming soon, praise the Lord, as we know it. As we know it, says 1 Peter 4 and 7. Therefore, we've got to be honest and disciplined in our prayers. Most important of all, we must continue to show deep love for each other.
Yes.
For the Bible says that love does what? Cover what? A multitude of sins. Praise the Lord. So we must build our foundation on righteousness. That's what the Christian must do. That's what the church must do. That's not what our president is doing. But we're not going to worry too much about him. We're going to put him in God's hand. But we're not going to sleep on it. We're going to do what we need to do. That's what we're going to do. We got to stay busy and do our part. God didn't call us to sit here and put our head. No, he didn't call us to do that. But he called us to be in the game Christians, active Christians. And all of us come. We have a gospel song of salvation that relates well to this message. And it's called My Hope is Built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but hold and lean on Jesus' name. On Christ, the Son of God, I stand. All of the ground is safe and sand. When darkness veils in lovely faith, I rest on him unchanging breath. Thank you.